and said he wants to join Derek's pact to stop the Scott has a plan. A very good, detailed, in-depth plan. He may be hurting some people in that plan, he may not be. And Scott just wants to make all the bad stuff go away and save his friends. So he has a plan, and joining Derek's pact is part of that plan, and that's all I can say. Can't say anymore.
Acting as if we didn't watch the next episode of the panel.
Okay.
The relationship with Allison's very much like Romeo and Juliet together, pulled apart. What can you tell us about the next big challenge in that relationship?
Well, the next episode that you haven't seen is Scott and Allison getting into a mix-up because Allison's a good person, just like Scott is, and she just wants to help people, and she has a family who full of werewolves, and a boyfriend who's a werewolf, and she's got basically two different lives. Like, one's a werewolf on her family side, the other side, she's in her own pack, with like Derek and Scott and Styles and Lydia and Jackson, so there's two different sides of her, and obviously she's very loyal to both sides, so when she's loyal to one side, it's going to get, what is going to happen? It's going to mess things up on Scott's side sometimes. So she can't make everybody happy, and Scott gets mad.
Scott's
motivations are they solely to protect Allison from Derek? He's in love with Allison, and he'll do anything to be with her, but if she's wrong about something, he'll tell her. You know, Scott has a very good heart, knows what's right and wrong, and won't let anything stop him from doing what he thinks is right. So if that means that Allison's wrong, he has to tell her to do something, then he will. But in a nice way. He's a very sweet guy.
How is the relationship between his parents going to evolve in the season? It just seems strange, you know, they're constantly...
Well, his mom is getting very suspicious about him. You know, he's acting really weird, his grades are failing, she thinks he's about his dad, who is non-existent. He's probably alive, but you just don't see him. He's gonna figure out whether to keep the lie going, because it's hard pretending to be like everything's okay, and that will take its toll on Scott. So sooner or later, he's gotta figure out what to do about telling his mom.
It was okay. No, it was good. No, it was great.
Just
wonderful.
Okay.
I was just, it's a long day for everyone.
I'm gonna just chug this espresso and throw up all the it's so gross. Have you ever had straight espresso before?
Yeah, with that reaction, sure, wonderful.
Yeah. I do that with my friends. I'll like get something and be like, oh, dude, this tastes like ass. Try it. Like, why? Like, I just want you to go through what I went through. Like, if my friend did that to me, I'd be like, oh, okay, that's fine. I'm gonna try.
That's real friendship.
That actually segues into a question. With, you know, wanting your friends to go through what you're going through. Where do you see Scott's relationship with Styles? Because God's Styles, like, sucks watching everyone around him.
Yeah,
change it to one thing.
Styles is basically Scott's rock. Without Styles, he wouldn't do anything. He's very grounded and love of the Saints. Styles is awesome at being a best friend and sidekick because he researches and Scott doesn't, and he just kind of listens to Styles. But you know, their relationship, their friendship, would be tested because Styles, like I said, can't defend himself as good as well as I can. So he will. Styles will be confused as to whether he wants to keep helping Scott in his battle against the evil heroes. As Derek Fish puts it. Things might get a little rocky, but Scott always understands. You know, Styles is like, I need to back out for a second. Be like, I totally understand, man. You can handle it.
It seems like Scott's very black and white, like as far as his loyalty, as far as like the. Oh yeah, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, I think, well, let me flip.
Off white.
Yes, off white, very big coffee. Coffee, I understand. But my question being is that it seems like he's very not judgmental, but he's always like very like straightforward, like this is right, this is wrong. It seems like everything so far in the season is kind of like overlaying. Like at what point do you think Scott's gonna get to that breaking point where he's gonna have to make a decision, like where his loyalty lies? Like how is that?
When he's actually been making those decisions throughout the season.
Yeah. But like the big actual like collision of everything.
Like
with Allison and like with Allison and his mother and you know, trying to balance that with I know, you can it's okay, sorry. You can come back to that later.
No, I mean, can you just ask it again?
The black and white thing threw me so off, I didn't even know how to even ask it anymore. To be honest, I'm like, what was I asking? His moral code. Yeah, I mean, he's very much, I'm loyal, this is my friendship, I don't like to keep secrets. And that being said, his relationship with, you know, with Allison, the relationship with his mom seemed to be kind of compromising what his beliefs are. At what point, in the season do you think he's going to have to, like, fess up and kind of, like, you know, tell his, like, mother, like, the truth? Like, at what point do you think he's going to...
It's killing Scott every day that he doesn't tell him. And, shit, I just came up to something really cool to say. I'm going to put this over here. Oh, seriously? Okay, pulling it right now? I'm going to answer this question.
Okay.
What did I just say?
Mother, Allison, Scott.
No, what did I just say?
Oh, you said that it kills
Scott's lie. Okay, yeah, it kills Scott's lie. So eventually, he will be too overwhelmed with not telling his mom the truth about what's happening to him. And he will maybe have to shed some light on what he's doing.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay, your excuse.